All praises to the Most High. Fair use, copyright disclaimer under Section 107 of the Copyright Act 1976. Allowances is made for fair use for purposes such as criticism, comments, news reporting, teaching, scholarship, education, and research. We'll be using all of those today. We're here for all of those reasons. For fair use is a use permitted by copyright statutes that might otherwise be infringing. We're using this video because found this video and these brothers here. They are reviewing the thinking and the behavior of these Christian churches. Basically, that's what we're doing. When we get on here and interview people, we're surveying people and surveying their thinking. We're comparing Christianity with the truth of the Bible. You got to remember what we're doing. What the Israelites are doing, they're indicting the world for believing in the doctrine of man. Trying to show our people that they have been bewitched, they're under a strong delusion, and the teachings of man have led us far away from the laws of God and the mind of God, and led us down a road of destruction, following the religions, the doctrine, the man-made doctrines of this world. Because Satan, the god of this world, has designed the things that we follow to cause us to be worshiping the beast. Now that's the bottom line. We're worshiping the beast. The Bible said, you cannot take the mark of the beast. And really, we got to rethink that. Now, we're thinking now the mark of the beast is a lack of melanin. And the thought that we are gods and we don't have to worship a god because we are all gods. That's the Greeks. That's the Romans. That's that mythology. That's that pagan thinking. It's the thinking. You got to remember, it's the thinking. It's the super ego. What you put in your mind to help you balance right and wrong can't be wrong and wrong. It's got to be right and wrong, the knowledge of good and evil. We're experiencing the knowledge of evil that Eve and Adam introduced us to. If you look up the knowledge of evil, it says, knowing what it means to be subjected to evil. We are in captivity by evil, and we are subjected to evil from our thinking to our doing. And what we're doing is trying to show people what is evil. Because they think evil is some spiritual guy with horns on his head and a pitchfork. But evil is what you suffer in this kingdom because of your thinking. What you suffer in this earth as an Israelite because of your thinking. Thinking and your delusional thinking, you've been bewitched and you're suffering evil, pain, torture. Hatred, all of the things that make you feel horrible on this earth. It was never meant to be. That's Pandora's box. We open Pandora's box and unleash all the evil things on us that could possibly, that exists, really. Everything evil comes from us opening that box, which doubting God and believing the lie that God is trying to keep us from enjoying the good things out of life. And he don't want us to be like him. He don't want us to be gods. We are gods. We could be like him if we just eat from his, from Satan's, from the knowledge, the tree of knowledge of good and evil. So this is what's happening right here. This is what we see happening. You tell me this ain't what we see happening. This is a man who is the number one leader of the religious churches, black churches. Black people look up to him all over the earth as being the first and foremost authority on how black people, and a lot of white people follow him, so-called white people, so-called black people now. You know, we know who we are. Edomites and Israelites follow him, and Africans. They take his lead on how you should be as a man of God in the church. In life, if you want to live a good life, be like, take T.D. Jakes' advice. Even in all the Edomite entertainment centers, why do they come down and get this man? Why don't they go get Nate or General Yohana or Shabak, Priest Khan, Sons of Thunder? Why don't they come and get these men and ask them, what does the Bible say about our behavior and how we should behave? It ain't because they don't like religion, because they go get this man and ask him, Doctor, what should the human mind be doing and functioning and thinking in this certain situation? They go get him. Why? Because he will not inject the truth into any of his lifestyle. So we see that here. That's what we see here. We see evil and evil in his superego. He don't know right from wrong. And if he do, then he's a stiff-necked two-thirds leading people. And the Bible say, woe, death unto the shepherds that lead the flock astray. Death. He's got a death wish and a death sentence on him for being who he is, because he's leading the flock astray. He's not telling the people who they are, and he's following that secret treaty of Verona, delivering all the people, the Israelites, over to the Pope. Catholic doctrine, Christianity, he delivered you to Christianity. And even when we catch him with red-handed and tell him that's wrong, the Israelites were trying to tell you, you are in sin, brother. So he put his trimmed beard up here, and he, no fringes, and he begins to perform in the church. Hollywood, Hollywood. He's worshiping the image of the beast, all right? Let's go. Let's listen to some of this stuff. It ain't funny, man, but see, these, let me show you again. Let me show you something else. These guys, they call themselves heathens. Now, I don't know what they think outside the camera about themselves, but we look at them as being heathens, and they don't care. They say, that's okay. Well, that's what we're going to be. If y'all look at us as that, and we getting your attention, then we're going to keep playing these roles because we like that attention. So that's what they're doing. But they can look at this man and say, that's not church. That's not what God say, the way God say we should act. Why? How can a heathen judge a man, the top number one religious leader for his race? How can he judge him and say, just by watching him dance, that's not the behavior of who you say you are? Because the truth has came back on the earth. That's why these pastors and these men are in culture shock. All the white supremacists, all the people with white privileges, all these entertainers and people on top of the black society, on top of black society. All of our black people, so-called black people, Israelites who have made their way to the top of our society and being praised by the wicked, they look down on us. And not only that, as they look down on us, the truth is coming out and shining where they were hiding in darkness. The truth has come out, a light that's shining on them and exposing them to their ungodly behavior. And so these men are laughing. They know it because they can see the truth. These people in darkness, they think that the darkness is covering them. But the Most High has exposed these wicked preachers and wicked leaders. All those people that's with them are their wicked leader, or wicked leaders too, because they lead in their community. They go back and take this false doctrine back to the people that's watching them, because they're successful. Most of the people that go to the church is successful. Well, who do poor people listen to? Successful people. Before they'll listen to poor people who's telling the truth, they'll listen to a successful person tell a lie. The Bible tell you that. The rich man gonna get all the attention. E.F. Hutton, right? Okay, so these people are the wicked leaders. They're taking that behavior and that lifestyle back to the community, to their children, who's taking it to their friends. And they're all one big happy people hid in darkness. And to the Israelites, God sent the Israelites out to blow the trumpet and to shine the light on the world in their dark state. And that's what's happening now. That's why he didn't realize the whole world is looking at him. But there's another world outside of his church, the people that agree with him, the wicked. There's another world that the eyes have been opened. It's a whole army of people. Now, you are the people under pressure. The people that's been hiding in darkness claiming to have a monopoly and on how to live and get around the laws of the Bible, get around the mind of God, to hide from God. You can't hide no more. He see you. He put in his eyes. The eyes of the Lord go to and fro in the earth. We got the eyes of the Lord. That's why they're trying to snuff us out, because we are watching you. We are reproving you. Look at the wisdom of Solomon. They hate us because God set us down here to watch them and to point out their sin. So now they can't hide in darkness. They are always in the presence of the Lord, and they see that when they see us coming and looking at them. So let's see how T.D. Jakes react to this whole world criticizing him. The norm now the norm is you wicked pastors that don't follow the Bible are evil and wicked, and we don't like you. You are the people that God is going to remove from among us. Let's look.
If you try to
move past that commentary,
listen to
it. Move past that commentary.
Serious tip. If you fat,
that's just
beat constantly.
They ain't saying nothing.
By the way, you're gonna see him pulling a Biden by bringing his children on stage and grandchildren on stage to do this with him too.
And that's his granddaughter. Now I like what this guy said about this scene here. Look at him looking at his granddaughter.
Is that his granddaughter?
That is his granddaughter, yeah.
See, let me tell you something, man. Hold on, let me get my thoughts together. Even in my fallen state.
You hear what he said?
My granddaughter can't dance on me like that.
See that?
No.
Now, this is supposed to be the wicked.
Get away from me. I'm not sitting there listening to that music with you. That's just crazy, man. And you're a pastor. But people follow this guy. So he must have got some kind of stronghold on him, bro.
He do.
See, he got to listen to this. This is people who don't go to church and don't claim to be religious. But they, now that the right has come back on the earth, the truth and the right, the mind of God, is being shared with the people. Now, people who don't, hadn't been going to, through focusing on right and wrong, they're now focusing on it. And the people who have been in the dark, I'm repeating myself, are being exposed.
Okay, I want people to understand, this is on his show.
In other words, he hired
an actual police officer. This is a stripper. Okay?
In other words, he hired this stripper to be on his show. We don't need to...
Police dressed up stripper on the T.D. Jakes show.
Imagine that conversation.
Okay. I want to know how he got God to approve this one. Anyway, look. I'm just saying, I want you to make sure you can see in the background. I'll pause it here for a reason, so people can't say we use green screen or something.
Okay. Yeah, all them jokes, man.
I don't know what to say. But can you...
Tell me, why is his hand in his pocket like
that? No.
Wait a minute. Now, that move right there he did, we saw one of the Israelites do that move, and they talked about him about it, too. But anyway, that's a homosexual move. You know, that's a man acting like a woman, postured like a woman. You shall be known by the look, by your look. Okay, we see T.D. Jakes is amused by that. But he seems to think he did nothing wrong. You're going to hear him say that over and over again. He's good. He's good. Only God is good. He's a preacher. He know Jesus said that. So if Jesus told you don't call him good and y'all ain't good, only one good, that's God, why do you keep saying I'm good, pointing to yourself, I'm good? I'm going to tell you something about this man. He understands psychology. He understands brainwashing. He understands subliminal messages. I guess I'm saying it right. So let's keep looking.
Can you tell me why his hand's in his pocket like that?
We don't want to talk about that. We know why. And for him to stand there with his hands in his pocket like that, holding himself in front of all those people, that's got to be a room full of people who think like he thinks. He knows that. They're perverted. They all probably have been at one point or another, they have been in some kind of sexual relationship or heard about, and they know they can feel safe. This is a safe space for all the wicked, they think. Now look, they got cameras running around, and he's promoting homosexuality, just God and Savior. And he has a lot of participants. Let's look at it. See that crowd? And that's what they enjoy, that paleness of the crowd. And you know, them pale, them people without that recessive gene, man, they all for this. And to be able to come to a church where they don't have to worry about nobody robbing and killing them, and good Christian people that believe like them, and to be able to freak off like this, man, this is better than a nightclub. You get to freak off and be everything you want to be with your Christian friends and your pastor's there holding himself. Everybody wants to take a chance, take a turn on each other. This is an orgy, man. This is the setting of an orgy, beginning of an orgy. Why the stripper? Why the homosexual stripper? Look at T.D. Jakes. And he would not take his hand out of his pocket. But everybody up there with him, you know, everybody in there with him. And you can see him grabbing himself. Look at these brothers. That's it. That's the proof. Okay. That's all you need. Now let's go. Well, they're doing a lot of talking right here, but let's go listen to him, how he explains this. Himself. He said, go ahead.
Here you go. His response to the allegations. And it's rich.
Would y'all please do me a favor and stop worrying about me and give God some praise and honor and glory? I can feel you. I can feel you. Would you just give God some
glory? You see, when he starts saying give God some praise, his hands were down to his side. But then he said, I'm good. Watch it again. He's using that, he's relating God, I'm good. That saying I'm God, because everybody know none, that good should not be referencing nobody but God. We're gods. This is Greekish fashion. We're gods. We're good. And I'm not feeling bad about being found out, because I got you people. You all think like I think. And that's all I need is my money, my power as God over, you know, the head God over you guys. You guys look up to me. I'm God. You look up to me. I'm good.
Glory and praise, and go ahead.
He said, praise me.
I am fine.
He said, lift him up. But I'm good.
I'm good.
I'm good. Why do you use another word?
I'm the man for the job.
He picked words, man. He picked words. He said, I'm good. He said, they're going to attack me, but I'm the man for the job. I'm fighting for y'all. I'm fighting for our homosexual freedom. You got to listen to the what's not being said. It's called critical thinking. You got to listen to what's not being said, too.
I'm good. Come on.
I'm good. I'm God. Give God some praise. See how he did that? I'm good. That means I'm God. And then he pointing to himself. Why is he pointing to himself like that? Come on, y'all. Praise me. Come on. Praise me. These men are right. That doctrine promotes self-God, self-exalting. That Christian doctrine promotes self-exalting through all of his man-made teachings, through all of his days, celebration, all of his feast days, what they call it, holy days, holidays, keep none of his holidays, keep none of his customs. When you keep his customs and you use this Christianity to worship God, then you are an idolater, you are worshiping the image of the beast. The beast set this image up for you to worship. The Pope. The Pope did that. The Pope changed all of that. Changed Saturday from Saturday to Sunday. Changed you don't have to keep the laws. Changed the calendar. Changed the name of the months.
While he's saying that, it's perfect he said that, because I do have a clip of him saying that he is Jesus, but he ain't saying it in so many words. In case you're wondering why he's saying give God some praise while pointing at it.
Now, I've heard several people, many Christ shall come, and many Jesuses, many shall come saying that they are Christ. Now, that's the ultimate, sign that your brain has been overtaken with evil when you start claiming to be Jesus Christ. All of our false teachers and leaders, they eventually lead into that. Even Ariel, was that Ariel with the Israelites? When he went off into self-worship and wanted people to worship him, a lot of Israelite camps now, they're in self-worship. They want people to worship them and praise them. And that's why they're out there doing what they do. That's why they set up. But even one of the leaders for the Israelites began to say he was God. He caught AIDS, went to jail, and died. Woe unto the pastors that scatter God's flock, Yahweh's flock. Woe, you're going to die. Destruction, he's going to remove you from among us. All of the countless other preachers that died in the midst of a scandal. But the scandal exposed them. People found them out. The scattering of the sheep, the flock scattered. And they're just out there wondering. And that's why God sent men out there. And in this same verse here in Jeremiah, was it 23 and 1? In this same verse, he says he's going to remove them. He's going to destroy them and remove them from among us. You can't stay among us. Just like them guys, just like these young men that's monsters, the young people that's monsters, we have people like this that's leading, cause us to error, and he's going to remove them from among us.
Himself, it's intentional. If you think I'm lying, again, it ain't going to be ours that do this. It's going to be his. Okay? All right.
Relax. Give God some praise. We're not going to let the devil take over our service.
No, he already did.
And I'm sure I'm gonna let the liars stop me. I'm gonna give y'all an extra prayer. Y'all looking at me like you're my physician, trying to see if I'm good. I'm good. You can't do this 50 years.
Trying to see if I'm good? He said, you can't do this 50 years. In other words, hide in darkness, still play church, still get rich, still make people think that you are following the teachings of the Most High. You good? You good with that video we just showed? You promoting that and nothing's going to happen to you? You all right? He believes the stuff that the beasts have taught. He believed that you can do what you want to do and all you have to do is apologize to the Most High and step right over and keep going in business as usual. Watch this.
I've been in a storm. I've been up under attack. I'm fine. He done is with me.
In other words, he's been living with his condition. And he's saying, I've been all right so far. I kept going. Y'all ain't got to worry about this thing falling and needing another leader. I'm going to be all right. God going to let me live because I'm a God. I'm a God. I'm fine. I'm good. Only God is good. I'm good. I'm so close to God that I can do what I want to do. Watch.
More than all those that are against me, I'm fine. Glory to God. Hallelujah.
He said, all those that are against him, he's fine. He's going to stand. Y'all not going to be able to bring him down. Who can bring me down? Ain't that the mindset of Esau? Ain't that a scripture? Who can bring me down? Google that. They said in the last days, they'll be saying, the wicked will be saying, who can bring me down? Look how fortified we are up here. None of those that are against me can bring me down. Y'all ain't going to touch me up here. I'm going to still be having church up here. Uh-oh, that's dangerous, boy.
Yeah, let's lift up the name of Jesus. Thank you for loving
he
me.
He said, just lift up the name of Jesus. Now, we don't know who Jesus is to you now because you have ignored the mind of God. You set up false You got false teaching, you set up false way stations, and you're sending out the flock with false teachings to go everywhere and get everybody involved in. It's a melting pot in here. You got all kind of heathens in your congregation. You're fine. You have built this thing, and they are not going to let you fall, are they? Let's see.
Thank you for praying for me. Thank you for being.
Now, see, he's deceived. Now, these people are just like him. How could they pray for you when they are just like you? They are following you. What they need to pray for you for? You say you fine. Ain't nothing touch you. Everybody in there understands the same because they just seen you sitting there holding your crouch in front of all them women and kids and strippers in the church in front of all the women and kids. They were participating. The women and kids was participating in the lewd acts. But you fine. You blind as a bat. You groping groping in the darkness at noonday. All this light out here shining, showing us what's right and wrong. And you are still deceived in your Christianity, in your bad behavior. Stealing people money, putting people out stealing their money from their family, but y'all okay. Y'all entertainers. This is the entertainer. This is what the entertainer do. They get you to worship the image of the beast. That's what they're here for, to bring us to the image of the beast. Well, we read the Secret Treaties of Verona. Go back and look at the video. You know what? Google it. Read the Secret Treaty of Verona. This is the Secret Treaty of Verona is the mission statement of all the religious leaders and everybody who call themselves a part of the United States government, a part of white supremacy.
Concerned about me. I can feel you. I can feel you. I'm okay. Feel you. Come on. Come on. I'm good.
She opened up her quiver to all the arrows. Every evil spirit, come on in. Come on in. He's inviting all the evil spirits in. You see that? That's what he's doing. He's inviting all those evil spirits into him and the congregation. Come on in. Come on in.
I'm good.
I'm God.
I'm good. I know the truth.
I'm God. I know the truth.
He know the truth.
You don't know the truth? Yeah, yes, you do. But the Bible said, let me see. I'm going to read that. 2 Thessalonians. You might know. It's a whole lot of Christians know the truth. They sitting up here looking at the truth. The Israelites are showing them the truth. You sitting up here looking at it, brothers and sisters. Y'all looking at the truth. Here's the truth. Here's the answer to that. Let's see. 2 Thessalonians 2. Let's go 8. Okay, let's see. For the mystery of iniquity I need to be down here. Okay. Let's just read it. For the mystery of iniquity doeth already work. Only he who hath let will let until he be taken out of the way. Now, at some point, those seals are going to be removed, and all destruction and punishment, all everything is going to be released on the wicked to destroy the wicked, right? He's holding them back. He's holding back the four winds of destruction now. He's holding it back. He's releasing a little bit. It's all going to be released on the wicked doers of this earth very soon, okay, at some point. And then shall the wicked be revealed. See that? They're being revealed. We know that it said the mystery of iniquity doeth already work. He who letteth will let until he taketh away. So he has taken away the covering. And he's allowing everybody who's these wicked leaders who causing us to error to be revealed so we can stop following them. Although they're going to be destroyed, but the main purpose is revealing them so we can see them for who they are. We can see right and wrong and who's leading us the wrong way, whose example we shouldn't follow, okay? And then shall the wicked be revealed with whom the Lord shall consume with the spirit of his mouth. The word of God is consuming them. The truth is coming out. Everybody know the truth. Even these people here sitting here, they don't claim to be in public. They don't claim to be religious or God-fearing people. But they know the truth, right? They know the truth. They point to a lot. They point to this behavior. Consumed with the spirit of his mouth and shall destroy with the brightness of his coming. The light is shining on them. He's destroying the wicked. And they're working in their positions and their strongholds in the earth. He's tearing down those altars, bringing down every imagination that exalts itself against the mind of God. He's doing that with the brightness of his coming. He's coming. So as this stuff happening, we know we're getting close to his coming, right? We close to his coming, y'all. Hallelujah. He's coming back to set this thing back in order. And the brightness of it, the closer he get, the brighter the light get, the brighter the truth get. And the more revealed, their evil working is being revealed to us. Even him, ninth verse, 2 Thessalonians, 2nd chapter, 9th verse, even him whose coming is after the working of Satan with all powers and signs and lying wonders. He's going to destroy Satan. You know what that means? That means the small hats, they stronghold got to be destroyed. Babylon got to be destroyed, and everything they believe, their stronghold, their doctrines got to be destroyed and taken down. Their policies, their military, all of that's coming down. He said, even him who's coming is after the working of Satan. So in other words, that's the governments, everybody to hold us in captivity, hold this doctrine in place, the popes, all of that is being destroyed right now with all power and signs and lying wonders. They are lying, and all they lying signs, they Hollywood, they tricks, all that is being destroyed right now. And with all deceivableness and unrighteousness in them that perish because they receive not the love for the truth that they might be saved. See, everything that they believe in is being exposed and destroyed, being set in place, being looked at as a fraud. They're being indicted for all their crimes against the Bible and against the people. All of that's happening now. This is Esau's trouble. We're seeing it. This is the wicked trouble. They in trouble. He said, I ain't in no trouble. Watch this. Wait. He said, I ain't in no trouble. Wait, I want y'all to see this. I know y'all saw it. And for this cause, God shall send them a strong delusion that they might believe a lie, that they might be damned who believe not the truth. He didn't believe the truth. He heard the truth. He didn't believe, said, ain't no harm going to come to me. I'm all right. But had pleasure in unrighteousness. He believed not the truth because his pleasure in unrighteousness. Only pleasure in unrighteousness can overcome a man and make him stand before people who, you know, he having so much pleasure doing what he's doing. That's all he's concerned about, the people that's in there with him. That's all he's concerned about. He ain't worried about what we thinking or we praying that God expose him. And what's going to happen when he get exposed? He ain't thinking about none of the consequences. That's because his super ego is full with evil. Both sides, he can't balance out.
But he good. Yeah, he good. Well, he told you. You said he got. He think he got.
Yeah. No. Okay. All right.
Because you ain't got to be nervous. You ain't got to be uneasy. You ain't got to be in trouble. Come on.
You ain't in trouble. You ain't got to be in trouble. Just because they saying you're in trouble, that don't mean you really in trouble. You shall not surely die. God knows you'll be like him. You know, people, they don't want you to experience this pleasure. People that's against us don't want us to have this fun. We having pleasure, we fun, and God is okay with it. Let's see.
Come on. Would you help me welcome our internet audience that's streaming online? Come on, give God a praise for all of them. Thank you for tuning in, logging in, looking in, praying in, watching in, discerning in. Whatever brought you in, I was glad that you were here.
You think his hand was itching when he was scratching his hand? That was a nervous tick. You think thinking and trying to think about what to say, you concerned about your itching finger? No. He's discombobulated in his spirit. He's not at peace.
And we greet you in the name of the Lord one more time for our streaming audience.
Streaming audience, right?
I feel closer to the Lord than I ever have.
That's a lie.
Hallelujah, I feel his presence.
That might be. He might be that guilt. He calling that guilt closeness to the Lord. He thanked the God. He in his mind, he know God is chastising him. He planned to say a quick little prayer and go on and hide from the people and make people think he's all right and go on and deal with it by himself with the Most High. And hopefully he won't hopefully now that he know that he has a light, there's a light shining in the world, there's a big spotlight out called the Israelites. The black Israelite, black Hebrew Israelite. We the only people that ever came out and shined the light in darkness like we're doing now. Down through the annex of time, this is what we always do to get our people back to God.
It's with me right now. The anointing of God is in this place.
Lord, Ichabod. That's Ichabod.
Keep it moving.
Look it up. God is not in this place.
If everything was true, all I got to do is repent sincerely from my heart. There's enough power in the blood to cover all kinds of sin.
So that's how they think. I ain't going to listen to them. That's how they think. That's Christianity saying, if I do feel bad enough to where I get scared and feel like something's going to happen to me, and I feel like I'm in trouble, all I had to do is apologize to God, step over all the mess I done made, and go on and act like nothing happened.
That statement right there, that's the one I was waiting on. Listen, we know all too well exactly what he's doing.
Mm-hmm.
He's setting up the play.
Yeah.
For when all the evidence come out.
That's right.
Well, even if I did do it, all I had to do was, just go and say you did it, man. Go and say you did it. He just admitted that he did it.
That's true to me, he did. In a court of law, that's like saying, you can't prove it. He said, you say I did something, prove it. And she can't catch me, she didn't catch me cheating, he didn't catch me cheating. He can't prove his allegation. Where's his proof? That's what he's saying. He's saying now, if somebody do come up with something that look like I'm guilty, at that point, all I got to do is have a repentance service and everybody lay hands on me until my congregation, that's all I need to do. Because all I'm really interested in is these, they got all the money they need, man. All they interested in is staying in favor with the people they rule over. They want to be gods. They don't want to lose their position. That's all the Pharisees and all the wicked rulers and all of the people ever done, in darkness ever done. They don't want to lose their position. That's why they went against Yahawashi when he was on the scene. He was taking away recognition. He was taking away their glory that they was receiving from the people. Let's see what else. I'm going to end this.
Thank you.
I mean, but the evidence is better anyway, so.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, okay. Now, this is part.
Get ready. Nobody ready for this one. I wasn't ready.
I was not ready.
This is very important.
I was not
here.
Ready for this.
Now, I want y'all to remember what I was teaching you about. What we was teaching, I'm probably a lot of you already know it. This is a lot of time the courts, law enforcement use when they got a criminal, a suspect standing before them, and they try and decide whether they're guilty. They use a lot of this micro expression. It's when you hear something, your first expression when you hear it is your true expression. Now, when you think about, okay, I got to fix my face, that comes a few seconds later. But we want you to look at the micro expression, the first expressions as he's talking, that his children, who know him very well, look at their expressions, and they're going to tell you whether he's lying, whether they believe him, is he being authentic, or is he a goddamn liar? What we say, Job 9 and 20. If I justify myself, this is what he's doing, in a way, justifying himself in a roundabout way. My own mouth shall condemn me. Let me get that right quick. We read it before. Okay. Job 9 and 20. If I justify myself, mine own mouth shall condemn me. So in other words, he's going to, when he go to trying to justify himself, he gonna be saying, you know, I really didn't do it. I'm not guilty, but you know I'm guilty. That, you know what I mean? That's called a fraudulent slip. Sigmund Freud, a fraudulent slip. In other words, you're slipping and telling on yourself by trying to defend yourself and hide. You're trying to go back and hide, but all at the same time you're waving the flag, waving the white flag. He said, My own mouth shall condemn me. If I say I am perfect, it shall also prove me perverse. My mouth gonna prove me perverse. I'm gonna say something perverted after I say I'm perfect. Now let's watch and see. Now we remember we're looking for God's micro expressions. The children's faces are a lie detector test for T.D. Jakes as he talked. And his own mouth, they watch what he said when he justified himself. Watch the faces of his people. Because his mouth is saying, you know, I'm a goddamn liar. I'm just sitting up here trying to defend myself from the truth. Anybody finding me out? Let's see.
Dignity my mother gave me. Mm-hmm. The strength of my ancestors.
What?
Oh, yeah, you got me. Dog, you know what I said? Listen what I said. I said I wasn't going to react. I was going to prove you wrong, but you got it.
Now, wait a minute. Okay, I'll let you talk, but didn't the Holy Spirit kill two people for lying under oath? Didn't the Holy Spirit, he's evoking his ancestors, and he wants them to testify that he is not promoting evil and leading people wrong, that he's doing everything God told him, the Most High told him to do. Let's see.
I'm not lying, I'm being serious.
The courage of my father. All of my ancestors stand up to me. You fight me, everything in me stands up.
Now, wait a minute. Now, your ancestors, we don't know who they are. We don't know who they are. We don't know what good deed, how close they followed behind the Most High, because they was in slavery believing the same doctrine they taught you.
First truth he has ever spoken. When you see him, all his ancestors stand with him because he invokes a lot of the voodoo stuff, man. This man.
That's true. That's true. It's all witchcraft and voodoo. Whenever you following and worshiping the image of the beast, you're using voodoo. To promote that Christian doctrine, you have to use mind control and voodoo. You have to use channeling. You have to channel these spirits and this thinking into your people's mind. Television, you have to television. You have to channel. You have to program. And that's what he's using, this concept. And that's what all hypnosis people and psychiatrists use. This witchcraft, this technique.
Functioning in the spirits, not spirit, spirits.
So how? How, bro?
How? Please ask a question. Go ahead.
All right. How did you get to the point that you can say things like that in front of your congregation? Yeah!
Yeah!
How did that happen? Is the stronghold that heavy?
Yeah, it is.
Mm-hmm.
He's right.
That is crazy. See? Okay.
Let's go ahead.
And don't forget to subscribe, like, share it up, like it up, and make sure you subscribe.
I'm afraid to say you're going to be dead rolling in a minute, okay? Video, when you start laughing, you will not stop.
Okay.
Watch I want to pray for people because I
watch
know
their faces. Look how she ducked her. Like look how she ducked her head. Look at his granddaughter's eyes looking up at him now. This is pure evil. We know this man is lying. We know what he was doing, had us doing, and participating with him in his wrongness is wrong. They know it's wrong. Do you look at their faces? Keep looking. Look at his wife. She's not so. That's not a supportive face. Ain't nobody mad at nobody for exposing him. In other words, they saying God is real. Your buddy's about to fall.
Shoulders are too small.
Look, when she looked up, she done heard him say that before. Shoulders too small. So he always had the big shoulders. I said, he always bragged about his big shoulders, right? See where he is? Is that his daughter that looked up?
Government you carry.
What?
Wait. Some people, because I know what it is to feel like your shoulders are too small.
So now he's trying to evoke sympathy from the people. He's trying to draw sympathy out. I've been carrying the world on my shoulder. Look what all I've done for y'all. I know what it feels like to be weak.
Government you carry.
The government you carry. He's the governor. He's saying he's Jesus Christ. He's the governor. That man was right. He's carrying the government of the body of Christ, which he think is everybody, but is the Israelites that he's totally scattering right now. He said it. You carrying, you governor. You the governor.
Your boy, man.
That's my boy. Don't put this on me.
Which your opportunities are going to come, and
yeah, he a news anchor.
Oh, okay, that's his head executive.
Here you go. Listen to this one.
Wait, look at their faces. Look at their faces, man. Now I don't know if they under pressure of, you know, when you in this life, you ain't like you, like they said. I ain't hiding it. I ain't true to myself if I'm hiding who I am. And the world is out now. The world of the alphabet people is out. They are almost at the top of the chart of society. Basically, they are. They run everything. They are the leaders in everything. They control all government and all jobs and all of that. They are in there. And if you go against them, they understand the power they have. And the people that surround those people in power will not go for them, come after them, and try to bring them down, because they know there's too many of them. It's a strong demon. Let's watch.
To which your opportunities are going to come, and getting the wisdom God give me.
I ain't looking at him, though.
He's saying the opportunities. Remember, when you talk to young people about opportunity, you telling them. You know how to control their future. You understand their future, and they know a lot of them people he pulled up here, they work for him. Their future is in his hands. They're in the dragon's mouth.
What to do in this moment, because sometimes the devil will use your temper against you.
Look where that lady looked down at him. Look where that lady looked down at
him. Due permission, man.
Look what
God give me the
wisdom. I ain't looking at him, man.
What to do in this moment, because sometimes the devil will use your temper against you.
See how she looked down? They looking him up and down. When you see people looking you up and down like that, you know, they thinking, you dirty devil. They thinking something bad about you when they looking up. And it might not be evil thoughts because they're evil. It's just that they know your whole heart. They done pulled your whole card. They already thought about who you is. Look at this man blowing his cheeks up while the man talking. They don't want to be there in their own face and in their skin supporting this man. That's his son, I think. And his son, wife standing next to him. They're not looking like the man saying, look at how they looking at him. These are young people. They don't want to be a part of that old creepy stuff. But they work for you, the only reason they standing with you. They work for you.
My mama would say it this way, he'll make you cut off your nose.
Mm. He'll make you cut off your nose.
To which your opportunities are going to come. And getting the wisdom God give me.
I ain't looking at him, man.
what to do in this moment, because sometimes the devil will use your temper.
Then what are you trying to explain? I don't understand a damn thing he's trying to explain, man. That show you he's trying to justify himself without you knowing what he's doing. He's a psychologist, dude. He's a doctor. He's a strong witch.
Against you. My mama would say it this way. He'll make you cut off your...
Nobody's nodding with him. Nobody's in his amen corner. You know they say something they say in church, amen corner. They run to your amen corner. Nobody's amening and nodding at him. They looking at him like, we're going to give you a straight face. We down here. We didn't expose you with our looks. We were very conscious about our micro expressions, conscious about that. So we did you. You can't go back and look at the video and say, hey, what was your look about? Come here and look at this. What you look down? What you do? They're watching their facial expression. That means they already know. There's nothing to shock. He can say to shock him. Him denying is already, they know that's what he's going to do. He's going to deny, 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 but he don't want you to know he's denying. So he's telling you, I ain't even going to discuss a claim to be innocent or guilty. I'm going to plead the fifth. Well, when you plead the fifth, that means you're guilty. The court treats you like you're guilty, like you have pleaded guilty if you plead the fifth.
Close to spite your face, and you have to be still.
You gonna see what she's saying? She nodded. Now she nodded to, if you get mad, you might do something that might hurt you. So I can't get mad, because I get mad and explode my mouth and try to justify myself why I'm mad, because then I say, the hell with all y'all, and then I start telling on myself. Because I ain't scared. I'm bold at this. I ain't ashamed of myself. I'm out. Everybody know I'm out. No, they don't. You've been fooling people. You said you used to be a gigolo. We know that's men and women. Nobody knows you wasn't delivered from that. These people following you, they didn't know their daddy was taking it up to where you put that to mama to that. Okay? They didn't know. They wasn't in there. And if they did, they hated you for it. If they saw you and you did stuff, they hated you for that, man. Because a righteous man will hate wicked. A righteous woman will hate wickedness.
Know that God is God.
Look at that man. Look at where they're looking at him. Man, ain't no man going to put himself in that position to where that kind of evil could be spoken of him. And these men, they don't understand how you could put yourself in there and put them in that light too. They working with you.
And as long as I am the senior pastor of this church.
Yep. Look, see his wife. See that little look she had on her face? Like, please, Negro. You ain't nothing. Now they getting that money now. They clapping. Everybody's clapping and lifting it up because they think if they this is an amen corner that's going to deliver us from this bad, me feeling some kind of way, feeling wicked. Feeling like we've been exposed, feeling like we've been following the devil.
As long as I stand on this deck.
What are these men clapping for? Because he did nothing wrong? Or is this out of embarrassment to try to cover up the true feelings that they are terribly, deeply ashamed of what their father has done to them? They know men don't take it up the rectum. Is that the norm in that church? That all the men take it up the rectum and nobody care? That they pass, they gonna follow a man that gonna ignore the scriptures and go get him some rectum treatment?
That's the bishop over this house.
Look, he's delusional. He really think he's still the bishop. Saul, you have been brought down. You ain't going to get exposed like this and God leave you up over that church. You just don't want to leave, Saul. Now the people got to scatter to get away from you. You scattered the flock.
I know who I'm called to. Amen. And my sheep know my voice, and a stranger they will not.
You see what he said?
Follow.
You hear that?
You hear that? You hear that?
And my sheep.
My sheep.
My sheep. My sheep. Hear my voice, and they will not. So in other words, he's saying that he got them people captivated under his voice. He's their God. He controls their life. He says whether they do well or not, because he's the leader of this organization. He had that pen and that checkbook in his hand. That pen and that checkbook is in his hands. See, he's looking at this as a company, a Fortune 500 company. And if you want to continue to do well, you have to, you can't come for him. You have to bow down and respect him. That's why he went and admired Puff Daddy. He admired these people because they run their cult exactly the way he wants to run his cult.
Yeah, okay. That is Jesus talking in the book.
Yeah.
People say they read.
Yeah.
Jesus saying that.
That's right.
He says he knows his sheep.
That's right. Them Jesus sheep.
Oh, okay.
See, these are supposed, this is this mindset that all these preachers got. These are my people. That's why you can lead them down to the slaughter and think nothing of it. And think nothing gonna happen to you, because you claim these people as yours and their life is in your hands. So when you lead them to the slaughter, you don't have a conscience because you worship the image of the beast. You don't have a heart. You don't have nothing in your superego like godly. Because you did away with that, with Christianity. And so these are my people. You lead them to the slaughter. Delivering
them. So now it's his sheep.
Yeah. He's delivering them.
He was just asking them people to give God praise while pointing at himself.
He's delivering them to the concept of thinking of we can sin and what I'm doing is okay and y'all can do it. And I ain't going to expose y'all if y'all don't expose me. We just go and be one happy family. Orgies in the church.
Wow. At himself. And the final nail in the coffin, sir, to carterize this wound that we've been watching. He finally addressed the actual elephant in the room.
Let's see.
I don't think he understands something when you hear that. I don't think he understands that there's no age limit on perversion. Okay?
Oh, yeah.
And anybody who has that kind of government on their shoulders don't have time to be playing with freaks.
You was, though. See what I mean? He just saying, if you got a big government on your shoulder, you ain't supposed to be somewhere playing with freaks. He just tried to justify himself and then said he was guilty. This scripture don't lie, man. This Bible don't lie. If I justify myself, then my own mouth shall condemn me. If I say that I have done no wrong, my own mouth shall prove me perverse. He just did it. Listen to what he said again real quick.
And anybody who has that kind of government on their shoulders don't have time to be playing with freaks.
I don't have time to be playing with freaks because I got too big of a government on my shoulders. That's what he's saying. You can count me not guilty because I wouldn't go play with freaks because I'm too busy. But you was there playing with them. We just saw the video. We saw the video with Puff laying his head on in your breast. And we saw the video with you admiring this homosexual stripper. Ain't there something about this truth? Let's hear what the brother's gonna say. I'm gonna cut it off, man. We heard enough. See where they ducked their head? Like his daughter ducked her head. Everybody know this truth. See how they standing back looking at it? Now look at ain't nobody winning, man. This ain't a group of people that's supporting somebody who's been good and you know, because he will let them speak. He ain't letting them say nothing. Hey, my daddy's of all men. We all men around here. Everybody be hollering out. I don't know what you talking about. Nah, his wife. I don't know what y'all talking about. He, you know. Nah, they know. He was there. He was messing around with perversion. With the perverted people. He got caught with the biggest pervert on the planet right now. At this particular time, everybody's calling him the biggest pervert, the biggest God man. He's under deception. He's being brought up with indictments from the people, from his peers.
Okay, hold on. Now, you see, would you call it a lie?
Yeah.
Would you call that a lie? Because I would call that a lie. I'm pretty sure we saw in the other video that you had time to party with the freaks.
Yeah. See, I didn't hear him. I didn't hear that commentary on this. I didn't hear him. Let's listen.
Dog. This is a serious question too. Is he actually, and I want to make sure I heard this right, is he actually saying in the other video, maybe not this one, that he was not at the P. Diddy parties?
He can't say that. He know they got proof on that. He can't say that. What he's saying is, he's saying I wasn't there. So he's lying. His own mouth proved him to be perverse and a liar. He can't justify himself because his own mouth just told on him. If he hadn't said I was there for another mission, I was sent to witness to these people, then, and I got on out of there. But he can't say that because he know they got videos of him doing stuff. And if he beat up Pip Daddy and them too bad, they'll expose him. And like he said, they'll cut their nose. He said, if I get mad and start swinging on people, then I'll be cutting my nose off to spite my face. So in other words, he's saying they will haunt, they will put it out on him, even though it might hurt them. And if he pushed them, he's crazy because he know they got stuff on him. Wow.
Video, I know you told me about it. He said he was at the fixing the, making peace with people so they can drive their cars and stuff like that.
Yeah.
What?
But.
So he said he was doing some kind of other work there, but then he got caught up in. I don't even think, if you was a man and operating as a man, I don't even think they would have brought the homosexual acts out till you left the scene. If you was just there, they'd have kept it real. Okay, T.D.J. says, Gary, get ugly now, Bishop. We still sinners, so we're going to tell you, we can bring the strippers out and the homosexual, do all this, you know. We get loose, turn it up. You don't want to be here. He would have left. They wouldn't have did it. They wouldn't have did that, man. They wouldn't expose themselves to somebody like him if they thought he was legit. He let them know, I'm legit. Y'all ain't got to worry about me. Let's have some fun. I'm doing what y'all do. Whatever y'all do, I'm going to do it. That's the only way you can go in them parties. All praises to the Most High. We don't want that to be the last.
In the other video, maybe not this one, that he was not at the P. Diddy parties.
I don't know how to say that either. All praises to the Most High. We're going to end it right here. Okay.